This is Jennet Ingle of Jennet Ingle Reads. I've been asked to show a video of how I sharpen a knife, and I'm delighted to do that, with the caveat that there's lots of different ways to do this, and that there are a lot of people who have also made videos on YouTube who are a little bit more scientifically minded about the way they sharpen their knife, who are a little bit fussier about precisely how sharp their knife gets. And I'm a big believer in let's just do what works. I don't need my knife to shave the hair off my arm, and I don't need my knife to slice a piece of paper hanging in the air. I really just need my knife to scrape a reed. So accordingly, when I check my double hollow ground knife to see whether it's sharp or not, I just scrape on my thumbnail as though I were scraping a reed, and if it feels like I might be able to have an enjoyable time scraping a reed, I don't worry about it too much. Objectively, I'm sure the knife could be sharper, but if it's sharp enough for me to be comfortable with it, for me to be able to do exactly what I need to on the reed, that's what I want. And so here's how I achieve that. What I have here is a double stuff sharpening stone from Spider Co. And I've got a link to that on my website from the advice and recommendations page, and I've got a link to that from the blog post that's associated with this video. It's very, very fine on this side, and on this side it's even finer. It's ceramic. So this is not the ideal tool for a very, very dull knife. I'll get to that in a second. But if your knife is basically in pretty good repair and you want to sharpen it every day or every couple of days to continue to make your reeds, this is the stone that I use. And it's not even terribly expensive, and it's simple, and it's light, and I can carry it around with me. So these are good things. Here's what I do. I have a really simple three-step sharpening process. I'm right-handed, so I'm going to be talking about the scraping edge, which is this one facing away from me, and the non-scraping edge, which is this one. I don't care if that edge is sharp or not. You see, I'm scraping backwards and getting nothing. That's because I don't care if it's sharp. I only want it to be sharp this way. If you're a lefty, obviously you'll just reverse in your mind everything that I'm showing you. Okay, three-step sharpening process. My first one is I'm going to lay the knife with my scraping edge face down. I'm going to lay it flat on the stone and then raise it to about a 10-degree angle, not a very big one. And I'm going to bring it back once or twice here. You can see that I'm diagonaling that blade across the stone. That's just to make sure that all of the blade gets covered with every stroke. Once I've done that, I'll flip it over so that the scraping edge is on top, and I'll raise it to about a 40-degree angle. 35, 40, not quite 45, that would be up here. And at this point, this is my main sharpening stroke, and I'm just going to pull it with a fair amount of pressure. Backward, forward, it doesn't matter. Just so I maintain that exact 40-degree angle between the knife and the stone. Once I've achieved that, I'm going to lay it absolutely flat, and bring it just back straight to me one time. And that is my three-step sharpening process. Show it to you again, sort of in real time. Scraping edge down, 10-degree angle, bring it back once. That cleans off the old burr and any gunk that's on the knife. 40-degree angle, a few times. Reasonable pressure. Lay it totally flat. Bring it back once. I check, and this feels great to me. I don't know if you can see, but I'm getting off nice little bits of my thumbnail as I do that. Now, sometimes a student will bring a super dull knife to me, and at that point I'm going to use a coarser stone. I have this Norton stone. It's, I think, the same as an India fine stone. This is a relatively fine, but certainly much coarser than my Spider Co. knife. And on this side, it's super coarse. I actually never use this. But I'll do exactly the same thing on this stone that I do on my little one. Take my knife, flat, 10 degrees, 40 degrees, and back once. Sometimes for a severely dull knife, I'll need to do a little, like, on that main sharpening stroke. I'll achieve that 40-degree angle, and then I'll just rotate, or I'll scrape back and forth a lot. I'll put a lot of pressure, because that's really what's giving you the sharpness. And finally, if the knife is really recalcitrant, I do have this diamond stone, which I just bought at the hardware store. It wasn't even very expensive. The side that says fine feels coarser under my fingers than even my coarser stone here, but it sure does get a razor edge on the knife really quickly. Now, it's not the smoothest edge, so after I do these coarser stones, I'll come back to my Spyderco and just run my little three-step process once or twice on that. I may even go all the way to the ceramic side if I'm feeling fancy to get the smoothest possible burr on my knife. But effectively, that's all I do. I really like to be the unfussy oboist. I like to carry one thing with me. I like to get done what works and then not worry about it anymore. So I hope that this video was helpful to you. If you have more questions, please let me know in the comments below, or you can reach me from my blog, proneoboe.com, or you can reach me from my website, jennetingle.com. I'd love to hear from you about this, or whether you have any questions about anything else reed-related or knife-related. And thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Happy oboeing.